What does it mean? Does it mean leaving aside what we have known? No, I don't think it means abandoning what we have known. I think it's reapplying what we know with a different lens. And that lens is that the struggle for transformation is already taking place. Where do we stand in support of that struggle? It is taking place in our own countries, in our own societies, in our own neighborhoods. But if our sights are focused 10,000 miles away, we are, in some ways, disconnected. Struggles are taking place in all our societies, and those struggles are the kind of questions that Ingrid has posed. So, how do we respond? We respond by reconnecting with those. So the first set of capacities we need is to reconnect. Reconnect with our own roots, reconnect with our soil where we stand, reconnect in the communities we live, in some fundamental ways. So for example, in track going forward could be organizing courses on how to do community organizing in Birmingham, or in Hague, or in Oslo, or wherever else. And you could therefore bring some experience of community organizing in Sao Paulo, or in Mumbai, or in Cape Town, or wherever else. So in a way, capacity, those were the kinds of capacity development initiatives which were in the 70s and 80s. We sort of abandoned them because we got busy doing other things. I think that organizing, basic organizing, is a capacity that we are not in touch with anymore. So maybe a series of workshops, what does community organizing mean? What does organizing around a cause mean? How does that organizing happen? And in 2011, some of the old tools will be relevant, but some of the new tools will happen. This is where you could use new technology, you could use new ways of relating, but not abandoning the old ways of doing community organizing, basically going around, talking to people, identifying a common cause, and saying, well, what are we going to do together? What else would capacity development mean for civil society going forward? I think we will have to begin to see the core of civil society's message. Today's conversation since morning has been hinting at various cores. For me, the essential core is solidarity, solidarity in the sense of humanity, common cause, justice, and justice which is universal, not selective. So around those kinds of values, various forms of organizing civil society take place. Some of them are spontaneous and informal, and some of them are more structured and organized. But if we want to enhance our capacity to promote these values in civil society, then in a way, we have to find capacity to relate, to work in solidarity, capacity to nurture relationships, capacity to promote a sense of being a part of the whole. A different form of capacity than capacity to prepare log frames and project plans. In any case, as Ingrid said and many others have said, we're not going to have any of that money anyway. So why prepare ourselves for the future where none of our capacities will be used? We always say, those of us who are in the professional business of capacity development, we always ask the question, capacity for what? And why build capacity for something which is not going to be there anyway? So I would recommend from tomorrow, if possible, abandon all this LFA and all this business. What's the point? And invest our considerable institutional and personal capacities, considerable as they are, to building solidarity, to building coalitions and networks of solidarity in civil society, starting from organizing them where we stand, not some distant 10,000 miles away. I was also therefore thinking about what will I see when I revisit Intrac on its 30th anniversary. Jeff, of course, concluded it in the beginning itself by saying it's 30th anniversary. No, it will take about 10 more years, Jeff. If I came to Intrac's 30th anniversary, it would be held in somewhere in one of those East London or South Birmingham kinds of places, that the people in the audience will be community leaders, some of them unemployed and on welfare, some trade union organizers, occasional priests or so, and ethnically, at least 60% darker skins, and what they will be discussing. First of all, they'll be having dark beer and not white wine. And porters, I think it's called, the earlier version of Guinness. And they will be discussing what? They will be discussing over porter's beer how they have recently acquired capacity to do an expose of the budget of municipal government, how they have acquired capacity to identify teenagers who are under the influence of drugs in various neighborhoods, to find a sport come cultural route for their re-engagement in society. They would be also talking about a cooperative that they have set together because one of the companies in the community had withdrawn and was closing down their factory, and people came together and got some of their own money and some of the neighborhoods. And in the closing ceremony of that 30th anniversary program with this group of people in East London or south of Birmingham, there will be a community theater program with musicians who have traveled in solidarity from Johannesburg and New Delhi. So we will be the bards, not the speakers. And our role will be to clap at the end of that conversation in that hall. You might think I am painting a scenario for Intrac which will lead it to doom. I don't think so. I think business as usual will lead it to doom. I think running the same courses over and over again will run out of participants. I don't know about the trainers. They periodically get tired, I guess. But in 10 years from now, a super, super advanced program on OD is not what we need. So I pose this challenge, first of all, to Jeff, and hope he will remain around in track 10 years from now. Of course, to Brian, who hopefully would have retired by then. We may well be giving him a farewell on 30th anniversary. But to all of us who share a sense of solidarity and connectedness with Intrac, we are here because of Intrac. We are here because we are part of an extended family of believing that nurturing capacities in communities, in leaders of the communities, in small institutions in the communities is an important building block for both well-being and democratic practice. So all kinds of capacity investment will be required moving forward, but it will be dramatically different from what we know today. So finally, in order to do all that, our institutions and we as experts in capacity development may have to unlearn a few things. Because in order to learn something new, we may have to say, well, let's unlearn this. I want to only tell you from my experience, learning has been fun. Unlearning is extremely painful. So, friends, in order to support that unlearning, not only for Intrac, but for Priya and for each one of us who is committed to capacity enhancement in our communities, so that they can take charge of defining the future as Ingrid was trying to present, we all need mutual solidarity and support because unlearning is going to be extremely painful. With those words, I invite you to a next 10 years of journey of unlearning, solidarity, and capacity enhancement. All the best in track. See you 10 years from now.